Warning, if you're not a fan of puns, then you should really turn this video off right now, because Astros Playroom on PlayStation 5 is absolutely full of them. From the opening cutscene of the PlayStation Studios logo, which replaces all of the characters with a load of Astro bots, to the various trophies in the game, like the ones for some of the collectibles that reference other iconic PlayStation games, or how about that very far point trophy which requires you to scale up to the top of a PS2 and then jump across various light guns to get to the one that was bundled with Farpoint the VR game. Or other trophies in the game, like the Wild Arms trophy which requires you to spin while shooting the paintball gun. Or how about that cool one when you have to find the PlayStation VR headset and punch the goggles, which then shows you clips of Astro's rescue mission being played? There are absolutely loads of them in Astro's Playroom. But if I had to pick just five, well, here are my five favourite Astro Playroom trophy funnies. That one bullshit PlayStation trophy. Number 5. So the fifth choice for me is the This Way Up trophy, which requires you to punch the PlayStation logo on the PS2 in the PlayStation Labo room. So this is the room that you fill up after you complete all the levels in a certain world. You'll eventually get one world for each console, with the PS5 coming in the middle for the final world. So this trophy just requires you to unlock the PS2, and I think you can probably do it on the fat PS2 as well, and just walk up to where the PlayStation family logo is and just punch it, because you can actually spin that on the real console, and I thought that was a nice little touch. Number 4. So this one is the Cool Hoarder trophy, which I picked because when I saw this pop up during the level after getting all of the collectibles, it just made me laugh, because it's just obviously a pun on the snowboarding game called Borders, and I just thought it was quite funny because it's like Cool Hoarder because you're collecting all of the collectibles. Huh? No? Just me then? Well, I thought it was clever anyway. So that's why it's my fourth pick, the Cool Hoarder trophy. It's also silver, which is pretty cool. Number 3. So next up is the Jumping Splash trophy, which requires you to jump in the fountain near the final goal of the level. So this one I just liked because, again, it made me laugh because it's referencing a really old PS1 game, and you actually get to see Jumping Flash in the actual game, jumping around. So this game was a first-person platformer where you controlled a robot rabbit who had like a jetpack sort of jump. And it was just a really cool early PlayStation 1 game that I really liked. And I was quite surprised when I saw this pop. Number 2. So this one is called Jason, and it requires you to shelter from the heavy rain in Memory Meadows. So this is clearly a joke revolving around the game Heavy Rain, which came out on PS3. So this level starts off sunny, but as you get halfway through it starts to rain, and Astro pulls out an umbrella that goes on top of his head, and basically for the trophy you just need to find this bush shelter and stand under it for a while, avoiding the heavy rain, and then the Jason trophy will pop up, which is like a key thing from the game. Because I challenge anyone playing this game to not just go, "Jason! Jason!" whenever they see that trophy pop up and have flashbacks to the original Heavy Rain. Number 1. You got a trophy, which requires you to pick up a trophy in the PlayStation Labo area. So this one, purely because I am a big trophy hunter, trophy fan, and I do this whole show about trophies, I had to pick this as my number one choice. So this trophy is quite simple. You just need to find the trophies that are stacked on top of a desk and pick one up. And of course, I went for the shiny platinum trophy because I wanted that one to be the photo for this trophy. And this was actually my final trophy that I needed in order to unlock the platinum. So it was also my platinum image of me holding a platinum, which I thought was pretty cool, to be honest. So that's my top 5. What was your favourite? Let me know in the comments below, because Astro's Playroom is full of really cool PlayStation references, characters and gags. So I really do recommend you play this game when you get your PS5. Well, all that's left to do is give Astro's Playroom a bullshit trophy rating of...
Bullshit.
Here's Sub-Zero! Now, Plane Zero!